The nude man, a sort of symbolizing the two separate strands of existence, the essential nudity of man.
This is Captain MacPherson welcoming you aboard East Scottish Airways. You've had your tea?
Here, little Nell from Dickens' old curiosity shop fits new nylon siphons into the asbestos-lined ceiling. But it's the electrical system which has attracted the most attention. Arthur Huntingdon, who Helen Graham married as a young girl and whose shameless conduct eventually drove her back to her brother Lawrence in Anne Bronte's The Tenant of Wildfell Hall, describes why it's unique.
Because, sir, it is self-generating.
The on-site building techniques involve the construction of 12-foot walling blocks by a crowd of farmhands from Tessa the Durbervilles, supervised by the genial landlady Mrs. Jupp from Samuel Butler's Way of All Flesh. The local council here have over 50 hypnosis-induced 25-story blocks put up by El Mystico and Janet. I asked Mr. Ken Very Big Liar the advantages of the total compared to other building methods.
There is a considerable financial advantage in using the services of El Mystico.
Of course they're safe. There's absolutely no doubt about that. They're as strong, solid and safe as any other building method in this country. Provided, of course, people believe in them.
And a Mr. Jarvis was electrocuted for shouting outside.
We admit there have been outbreaks of hanging recently, but the police are trying to keep the situation under control.
9 o'clock and time for mortuary hour. An hour of talks, tunes and downright tomfoolery for all those who work in mortuaries. Introduced, as usual, by Shirley Bassey.
Well, we're going to kick straight off this week with our mortuary quiz. So have your pens and pencils ready.
Turn that radio off and look lively.
Oh, well, it's about
mortuary hour, Mr. Wayne.
Don't argue, Battersby. It's mortuary dance time, Mr. Wayne.
Never mind that, Battersby. This is the big one.
Wait, Nigel. I've got this strange feeling we're being watched. Oh, my God, Bruce. It's a police.
The official result of the world hide-and-seek. Mr. Don Roberts from Hinckley, Leicestershire, 11 years, 2 months, 26 days, 9 hours, 3 minutes, 27 seconds. Mr. Francisco Huron, Paraguay, 11 years, 2 months, 26 days, 9 hours, 3 minutes, 27 seconds. A tie.
Tie, what a fantastic result. Well, the replay will start tomorrow at 7:30 a.m.
Oh, dear. That'll be the cheap laugh from next door.
Sorry I was cross earlier.
Oh, that's all right, dear. It's just that I get so sick of always having to be like a cheap laugh.
Yes, well, from now on, we'll be like ourselves.
Oh, Roger.
Oh, Beatrice.
But we're now getting some live pictures through from Algon. Harry, perhaps you could talk us through them.
Very little evidence of shopping facilities here. There don't seem to be any large supermarkets. There may be some on-the-corner grocery stores behind those rocks, but it's difficult to tell from this angle. It does seem to suggest that most of the shopping here is by direct mail.
We must remember that Algon is over 75,000 miles wide. The probe has come down in this area here, and we're really only getting signals from a radius of 30 or 40 miles around the probe.
Just these, then.
All right, this is a raid. My name's Lieutenant Gaspard, and this is Sergeant Manners.
Sir Philip Sidney, it is good to see thee on these shores again.
Shut up.
Francis, what idleness is this? Why, good Sir Philip Sidney, what dost thou here?
You are Sir Philip Sidney?
Possibly. But I may be Superintendent Gaspard of the Fire.
But who is going to do the cooking tonight? Roddy's got a mouth.
All right! Woo! This is a raid!
Oh, we are disgraced!
There you are, Maddox.
Cut the chat and get in the van.
Maddox, you recognise me?
Indeed I do, Sir Philip Sidney, and sad I am to see you caught up in this morass of filth. Ooh, that's a long one.
It'll be late if we don't...
Oh, thank you. You're very kind.
As it turned out, our chance meeting with the Reverend Arthur Belling was to change our whole way of life.
Good evening. Tonight on Is There, we examine the question, is there a life after death? And here to discuss it are three dead people. The late Sir Brian Hardacre, former curator of the Imperial War Museum. The late Professor Thin, until recently an academic critic and broadcaster. And putting the point of view of the Church of England, the very late Pleasantway Ross.
Diddle-o, fall-de-roll, far-de-dar, lo-de-do-de-do, fum-fum.
Mr. Burroughs, this is no common problem. You are suffering from a disease so rare that it hasn't got a name. Not yet, but it will have. Oh, yes. This is the opportunity I've been waiting for. The chance of a lifetime. I'll show them at the Royal College of Surgeons. I'll make them sit up and take notice. Thripshaw's disease, discovered by E. Henry Thripshaw, M.D.
Begun to worry recently that... Come in. Ah, Mr. Husband. This is Mr. Kirkham, one of my parishioners. This is Mr. Husband of the British Sherry Corporation.
Boxing tonight comes from the Empire Pool, Wembley, and features the main heavyweight bout between Jack Burdell, British Empire heavyweight champion, and Sir Kenneth Clark.
Morning, Mrs. Trepidatious.
Oh, I don't know what's good about it. My right arm's hanging off something awful. What's yours, Irene?
Basil.
I'm sorry, what's yours, Basil?
No, that's my star sign, Basil.
There isn't a star.
Yes, there is. Aquarius, Sagittarius, Darien, Toms, Basil. Try another one. What's Aquarius?
It's a zodiacal sign.
I know that. What's it say in the paper, Mrs. Flan-and-pickle?
All right. Afternoon, you will die. You'll be
good
very...
Good morning.
Oh,
morning, Doctor.
And how's the old arm this morning, Mrs. Icon?
Oh, it's still hanging off at the shoulder.
Morning, Miss Hanson. How are you today?
Not too bad, Doctor.
Okay, take it easy. Expecting any postal orders this week?
No.
Righto. Ah, oh, Mr. Rogers, have you got your unemployment benefits, please? Right, well, can you write me a cheque, then, please? Thank you very much. Soon have you down to nothing. Ah, oh, Mr. Millichove.
Gentlemen, should there be a fourth television channel or not? Ian.
Yes.
Francis.
Nope.
Sir A.
Yes.
Patrick.
No.
Well, there you have it. Tuesday will, Tuesday will. We'll be back again next week, and next week's great debate will be about government interference in broadcasting and will be cancelled mysteriously. Just starting on BBC One now, Victoria Regina, the inspiring tale of the simple crofter's daughter who worked her way up to become Queen of England and Empress of the greatest empire television has ever seen.
Ah, this is my Lord of Buckingham. Pray welcome, Your Grace.
Thank you, Grantley.
This is the 15th Ideal Loon exhibition, and we took a good look round after it was opened by its patron. Here's Kevin Brooks, the digger duffer from Down Under, who's ranked 14th in the World Silly Positions League. This kind of incoherent behaviour is really beginning to catch on Down Under. There's Norman Kirby from New Zealand, whose speciality is standing behind a screen with a lady with no clothes on. In real life, Norman is a gynecologist, but this is his lunch hour. But for sheer pointless behaviour, you've got to admire Brian Broomus, the battling British boy, who for 2 weeks has been suspended over a tin of condemned veal.
And the winner is number 41, Mr. Justice Burke.
Dennis Moore, riding through the land. Dennis Moore.
more than this fool without a merry band. He steals from the poor and gives to the rich. Stupid bitch. He steals from the poor and gives to the rich.
Why did he? Blimey, this redistribution of wealth is trickier than I thought.
From Mrs. No Supper for You from Norwood in Lancashire, miserable fat Belgian bastard! Very good, very good. Thank you, Carol.
Oh, shut up, Melford. There's always next year.